Hi everyone, today I am going to give a lecture on centroid. We shall see about the derivations and the numericals included in the centroid topic. The very first one is centroid of plane figure. Okay, so this is a plane figure. So in this figure you can see a irregular lamina having the center of gravity as G. And this is being divided into six parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you can see 6 parts in this irregular lamina. So each and every part individually considered, and the G1, like G1 means the center of gravity of the first part, and G2 means center of gravity of second part. Likewise, for all 6 parts, we have considered the centroid point as well as area, that is A1, A2 means the area of part 1, area of part 2, area of part 3, part 4, part 5 and part 6. And the overall area is assumed to be A, capital A, you can see in the figure. And the overall gravity is G, that also you can see in the figure. So these are all the individual center of gravity and individual areas. So how to determine this centroid of the old figure means, just we know that the center of the old figure is capital G. So with respect to that, the x distance is taken as x bar, and which is parallel to y axis is taken as y bar, means x bar, y bar. So we need to find x bar and y bar for this figure. So not only this figure, whatever figure we are going to calculate in our further lessons, we need to know x bar and y bar. So for that, we are determining the formula in this presentation. So we knew that x1, x2, x3 are the distance of centroid from x-axis. See, individually if you take this first part, you know that the center of gravity is G1. So the distance that is parallel to x is taken as x1, and the distance that is parallel to y axis is taken as y1. So likewise you will be having x2, x3, x4, x5, x6, and the parallel y1, y2, y3, y4, y5 and y6. Okay, so they are explaining the same in this. See, let x1, x2, x3, etc. be the distance of the centroid G1, G2, G3, etc. Right. So we knew that the overall area A is equal to A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4 plus A5 plus A6. Okay. So the sum of moment, we knew that the moment means force into perpendicular distance. So if you take moment about y axis, means the force is treated as the area A and the perpendicular distance is x distance. So for y axis you will take A into x. Okay, so the sum of moments of the areas about y axis is A1 into x1, A2 into x2. See, you need to consider this A as a force, here a force, and the perpendicular distance as this x distance. Okay, so you will take a force into perpendicular distance. If you want to calculate the sum of moments with respect to y axis, means A1 into x1, A2 into x2, A3 into x3, likewise till A6 into x6. So the sum of moments is this value which you are seeing here. Right, we know that the overall moment of the plane figure with respect to y axis is A into x bar, means the overall, means the whole figure. So A into x bar will be automatically equal to the sum of the moments of the individual parts. So if you will be getting an equation like A x bar is equal to A1 x1 plus A2 x2 plus A3 x3, likewise. So finally, if you so the x bar will be equal to this divided by the denominator will be the overall area. So we knew that A1, A2, A3, A4 is nothing but the summation of AX. Okay, just change it as summation of AX divided by A. So finally X bar is equal to summation of AX by A. This is what you will be using for finding the centroid for all type of figures. And the same if you want in terms of integration means x bar will become summation of x into dA by A, because x means x into dA means smaller distance. If you integrate from if you integrate for whole figure, then it will be like equal to the summation of all distance. So you can write either summation of AX by A or integration of x dA by A. Okay, this you will be using only in the derivation. But the major, the formula which we are going to use in the numericals is summation of AX by A. Okay, this derivation is with respect to moment taking with respect to y axis. But if you are taking moment with respect to x axis, means the same will be written as a y bar is equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 plus a4 y4 likewise, and you will get y bar is equal to summation of a y by a. Okay, so these are the two formulas which we are now going to use for the derivations. So in the next slide we shall see the different derivations and how to solve the centroid numericals and the formulas used for centroids. Okay, so the first derivation is centroid of a rectangle. So we shall consider a rectangle of base B and depth D. So the dimensions are B into D. So whenever we calculate a centroid derivation or centroid numerical, it's mandatory that first we need to identify the center of gravity point for that particular shape. Since it's a rectangle, it is identified the G as this point. So the G will be at the distance of x bar from y axis and y bar from x axis, means the parallel distance from x is x bar and parallel distance from y is y bar. This is centroid distance. X bar and y bar is said to be a centroid distance. Okay, so we shall consider a small elemental area of base B and depth dy, because base B we can take, since see the old B we can take, we are taking only a horizontal elemental area. So the depth only we shall take as dy. Okay, the distance from x axis to the dy we shall take it as y. Okay, now we shall proceed with the derivation. We already knew the formula for y bar is integration of y dA by A, as we seen in the centroid of plane figure derivation. We know that the formula of y bar is integration of y dA by A. Okay, integration of you will fix means you need to fix the limits. So limits, if you see this figure, it is 0 to d, means the distance is from x is 0 to d. So just take the same limits 0 to d y dA by A. Okay, we need to find all this individual items. So the area of rectangle we knew that from the figure B into D. Okay, so the area of the smaller area means the elemental area of a rectangle is, see, its base is B and depth is dy. So B into dy, right? For A and dA, it's we have written the area formula, clear. So next one is, we need to substitute these things in the formula. So while substituting, so we knew that only for dA and dA we have found, right? Substitute that in the main formula. So you will get y b dy by b into d. So you can cancel this b in b and b. So take this 1 by d outside as like this 1 by d. So integration of y dy only you keep aside, and if you integrate this y dy, so it will become y square by 2. So y square by 2, if you integrate 1 by d into d square by 2. So finally you will get y bar is equal to d by 2. Okay, from the derivation we have found the y bar as d by 2. But while seeing this figure only, you will understand that the half distance means d is equal to y bar is equal to d by 2 and x bar is equal to b by 2. But as like rectangle, we cannot say for all the figures. That's why we are going for this integration derivation methods. So it is found that x y bar is equal to d by 2. So the next proof for the rectangle. So earlier we have considered a horizontal rectangular strip, but here we are going to consider a vertical rectangular strip like this, right? So what the difference between